Hey everyone, how's it going? I'm Dunker Slam, and I mainly stream on Twitch, but I'm posting this little quick Noita how-to on YouTube so that anytime people ask me on Twitch, how do I use explosive projectile, I can simply link them this video. So it's not going to tell you everything you need to know about the modifier, but it will tell you some general ways to use it. It'll give you somewhere to start. From there, it's up to you how far you want to take it. People have wrote some theses on this shit, man. There's a ton to this modifier, and it's a little odd. So here is the quick, brief summary of the explosive projectile modifier and how to utilize it. It is probably one of the best modifiers in the whole game, if not the best, and I'll show you right here why. So this is my starting wand, nothing special. It is literally the bare basic starting wand. If I use this little statue here, I shoot at it, you can see it tells how much damage I do. So the spark bolt on its own does 3 damage. The bouncing burst also on its own does 3 damage. The statue is telling you how much, how much when we hit an enemy, how much damage they will receive, So let's go ahead and put the 3 damage spark bolts back on here. And let's put this explosive projectile modifier on it. So this modifier will apply to this spark bolt. So before it was doing 3 damage, now it's hitting for 8. That's pretty garbage because you got to keep in mind the explosive projectile costs 30 mana. So for 30 mana, you're taking your damage from 3 damage to 8 damage. You're adding 5 damage for 30 mana. Not really worth. Not really worth. Nothing special. So from 3 to 8, we added 5 damage. Now, the bouncing burst, which also hit for 3 damage, whenever we shoot it at the statue, let's see how much we get. It does 328 damage. That is because there are hidden mechanics within the explosive projectile that make it potentially one of the most dangerous modifiers in the game, as I said. So yes, you can stack this. It is a little bit interesting. So let me show you how to utilize this on another wand here. I kind of just modded this in so I could give you a brief glimpse of it. But let's say we have the explosive projectile and we have one bouncing burst. It did 330 damage, right? We just showed that. Boom, 330. You can put a double and put two bouncing bursts. And now it hits for 656. It literally doubles it, right? This is insanely strong. If you're wondering why the damage is so much higher with Bouncing Burst rather than Spark Bolt, it's because some spells have a damage radius that the explosive projectile interacts with that allow for it to cross some hidden threshold that makes it do 330 damage, basically. It's always like a set 330. So you can see that because let's go back to this wand right here. Bouncing Burst, explosive projectile. It hits for 330. Let's add another one onto this Bouncing Burst. It'll still hit for 330. It's because once it crosses that that needed explosive radius, you can actually see it even says on explosive radius, once it crosses 30, that makes it a hit for 330, and you can't really increase it beyond that with explosive projectile, at least. Obviously, you can add, you could add 10 explosive projectiles, you'll still hit for the same, but if you did explosive projectile and then started throwing on some damage ups and other kind of modifiers, yeah, you could do a little bit more damage. But one last thing I wanted to point out is something like Spark Bolt. With one explosive projectile, as I showed, did 8 damage. With two of them, it does now hit for 330 as well. So you basically, to summarize this whole thing, explosive projectile on most modifiers, you'll need two, but on some modifier, or on some, let me reword that. On some spells, you'll need one explosive projectile. On other spells, you'll need two explosive projectiles. At that point, just memorize which ones need which to cross that threshold so that you can do 330 damage. Spark Bolt needs two. Bouncing Burst needs one. In the case of something like a Triplicate Bolt, it needs two. Because if you have one, you'll hit for 30 damage. If you have two, you will hit for 985, I think I said, right? 990. So there you go. That's explosive projectile. It is pretty crazy. It is safe to use if you stand under the explosives. They can ignite you, like you can burn a little bit, but the explosion won't hurt you for most spells. There are a couple spells in the game that interact very oddly with explosive projectile, and they can be dangerous, but I don't want to rant for too long. I've already gone on for too long, so I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up there. If you have any questions, post in the comments below. This is a small channel, so usually I can keep up with most comments, so ask whatever you would like, and feel free to stop by my Twitch channel. I stream just about every day. Deuces, y'all.